If you are a diabetic patient, you live with an insulin-dependent life, or you have high sugar and cholesterol level in your blood, and you fear that you might will have those diseases in near future, then there might be an easier and natural way to control all those diseases. A leaf a day keeps diabetes away. A leaf from a particular plant could potentially be used to treat diabetes and many other diseases. Costus Igneus, or commonly known as insulin plant, is a traditionally used medicinal herb. For the last few decades, its leaves are being used as a dietary supplement in the treatment of diabetes mellitus in several countries as an alternative of allopathic medicine. Apart from the reduction of blood's glucose level, this plant has been claimed to control total cholesterol and triglyceride level in human body. And there are numerous scientific studies and research works to back up those claims. In today's video, we'll do an in-depth analysis of insulin plant's benefit and find out whether it is truly a nature's miracle plant for diabetes or just another myth. If you find the video useful, please like and share the video, and also subscribe to the channel if you are new. Costus Igneus plant is known by a variety of names, including insulin plant, spiral flax, painted spiral ginger, and stepladder, due to the structure and pattern of its leaves. It is a perennial herbaceous plant native to Central and South America that can grow up to 2 meters tall. The plant is found to grow well in the tropical regions. It has been recently introduced to India, and it is cultivated as an ornamental plant in southern India. The plant is characterized by large leaves, yellow flowers and fruits. Its scientific name, Costus, in Latin means spiral or stepladder, which you can easily identify from the pattern of its leaf structure, and that's why it is also named as spiral flax or stepladder plant. You can grow the plant at your home or even in container as well. The plant is one of the easiest plants to grow from seed. You don't need to take much trouble because growing and maintaining this plant is rather easy. You need to treat the plant just like any other herb. It does well in average garden soil, but it prefers moist conditions. It is a very strong plant, requires very little fertilizer, and also it is resistant to pest attacks. Though the plant loves moisture, make sure that there is no scope of overwatering, especially during the winter. When the temperature is about 25 to 35 degrees Celsius, you can see the blooming of the insulin flower. The plant can be easily propagated by division of clumps, stem cuttings, or by separating the offset or plantlets that grow as runners. If you are looking to buy this beneficial insulin plant, you can get them as plant saplings from nurseries or some Ayurveda stores. If you face difficulties finding the plant, please let me know in the comment section. I will try to help you out by providing details of some nursery who sell those plants. The plant is packed with numerous benefits for our health. The nutrients found in the plant are protein, terpenoids, flavonoids, antioxidant, ascorbic acid, iron, phosphorus, calcium, vitamin B, and many others. But most importantly, researchers also found that the plant contains corossolic acid, which has some efficiency in treatment of diabetes without induction of insulin injection. With all these beneficial nutrients, let us see what are the medicinal values of this plant. Different parts of the plants have been traditionally used for the treatment of diabetes patients in southern part of India. Diabetes is a metabolism disease where the body cannot produce enough insulin, or the insulin stops response to the blood cells. Insulin is a naturally occurring hormone made by our pancreas that helps our body to use sugars for energy. Without enough insulin, the sugar levels in our blood will increase, and that will cause various serious health issues. The leaves of this plant are the most important part, which produces significant anti-diabetic activity. As the plant contains corossolic acid, it can reduce fasting as well as postprandial or after-meal blood glucose levels. The insulin plant also reduces many diabetic-associated complications, corrects the lipid profile, increases body weight, as well as insulin level in the body. Here are some scientific studies published in reputed medicinal journal, which claims that different parts of this plant exhibit hypoglycemic properties. They can reduce blood glucose levels by 50 to 76%. In a 2016 study, researchers found that the consumption of insulin plant leaves helped prevent postprandial blood sugar spikes in those with diabetes. An older study from 2010 found that after eating the insulin plant leaves for only 15 days, the insulin needs for all the diabetic patients decreased by half. All these case studies suggest that insulin plant is found to be very effective in bringing blood sugar levels completely under control. Apart from its anti-diabetic property, there are many other beneficial properties like antifungal, antibacterial, and antioxidant, which are found in insulin plant. Papers published in journals like European Journal of Molecular Biology and Biochemistry, Journal of Health Sciences, and Journal of Applied Pharmaceutical Science showed significant antioxidant activities of insulin plant leaves, stems, roots, and rhizome. However, all these experiments have been done on laboratory rats, so human trial on this subject is yet to be done. This plant is also used to treat cough, cold, lung infection, and asthma. Interestingly, some studies have been made which confirm that the insulin plant leaves have the potential for anti-cancer activity. In 2014, a group of Indian scientists published one paper in International Journal of Innovations in Engineering and Technology, where they studied the anti-cancer property of insulin leaves extract on in vitro breast cancer cell. They found that it was able to reduce the tumor size without affecting the normal cells. However, more studies along this line and actual clinical trials should be done in support of their claims. Now, how to consume insulin plant? You can eat the leaves of the insulin plant on a regular basis. Take a leaf, wash it and grind it properly. Dissolve this in a glass of water and drink it on an empty stomach. Follow the same procedure twice a day, preferably morning and evening time. You can also directly chew the leaf as well. You can also dry the leaves under sunlight and crunch them to make powder. You can store the powder in a container for longer use. You need to take 1 tablespoon of this powder 2 times a day in empty stomach. You can definitely see the positive results within 1 month of regular consumption of the insulin leaves. However, consuming insulin leaves may come with some side effects, including stomach upset and dizziness. Especially if you are insulin dependent, that is, you take insulin injection in regular basis, then always check with your doctor before starting it as a supplement, as it can lower blood sugar level significantly. However, long-term side effects of this plant is unknown and more research works are needed for that. All the research works that have been done on this insulin plant showed that it is an important medicinal herb presented with various useful pharmacological actions. Further studies on its medicinal properties are required to be done to make the consumption of insulin plant more assuring, reliable, and with fewer side effects for the welfare of mankind in the future. In conclusion, the insulin plant is a gift of Mother Nature that can help to control diabetes. Try to grow the plant at home and fight diabetes naturally. But apart from the insulin plant, do you know that there is another plant which has been used as traditional medicines in many cultures for over 2000 years? The fruit from this plant contains numerous beneficial nutrients including potassium, iron, calcium, copper, magnesium, sodium, zinc, phosphorus, and many more. And the fruits of this plant have been claimed to fight many of the diseases naturally. To know more about this plant, click the video on the screen. That will be all for today. Thanks for watching and see you next time in a brand new episode.